Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I introduce this Snapmaker J1S IDEX 3D printer to you. It is a 3D printer with a dual extruder design and is fully enclosed. Its nozzle can reach a maximum temperature of 300 degrees centigrade, so it is compatible with a wide range of filament materials, including PLA, ABX, HIPX, PC, TPU, and so on. The IDEX 3D printer means you can easily print in two colors or in duplicate mode, which can save a lot of printing time. The Snapmaker J1X is ready to use almost out of the box. Simply install the cooling fan and filament holder and start enjoying your printing. Without saying so much, let me take you on a look at the fascinating things about the Snapmaker J1X IDEX 3D printer. When using the Snapmaker J1X for the first time, the touch screen will pump up the calibration wizard for heat leveling, Z offset calibration, XY offset calibration, offset calibration check, and vibration compensation calibration. The calibration wizards are very detailed and make it very easy to complete. As for the heat leveling, the left extruder will touch the three metal sheets on the heat bed, and according to the prompts on the screen, manually rotate the wheels under the heat bed for leveling. As for the Z offset calibration, you need to loosen the two screws on the right extruder. The left and right extruder will touch the metal sheet on the lower right corner of the heat bed. You just need to follow the probes and rotate the wheel under the heat bed to adjust the Z offset height, and then tighten the screws. The Snapmaker J1X also offers XY offset calibration. The two extruders will touch the heat bed in sequence to obtain and calibrate their offset in the X and Y orientations automatically to ensure perfect print quality. After completing the previous calibration operation, the machine will print a building model with both extruders. By observing the model with the prompts on the touchscreen, you can check if the offset calibrations are successful. The last calibration is the vibration compensation calibration, which also requires printing the building model. After printing, looking at the model in the Y direction and select the first print on the screen, and in the X direction as well, selecting the area with the most and the present vertical ripples. Vibration compensation can effectively eliminate the impact of machine vibration on the XY direction during the printing process to obtain good printing results. The standout features of the Snapmaker J1X, functioning as an index 3D printer, lies in its dual extruders capable of independent operation. This means it can print things really efficiently. I tried out the fast print mode, going as fast as 200mm per second to print two benchy models at the same time and see how well the print resolved. The benchy model I used is 60mm by 30mm by 50mm, and it only took 24 minutes to print in fast mode. That's super quick. So in just 24 minutes, you can have two identical pieces, which is a big plus for IDEX 3D printers. The printing quality from the dual extruder looks really nice. Whether it's the smoothness of the surface, or the slow prints, fringe prints, or overhand prints, it's all pretty good. However, I noticed a bit of strings left in the bench printed with the left extruder. This may be related to the extruder's retraction performance and will require me to reset the extruder's retraction parameters to eliminate the string residue. This issue will be discussed later. Next, I test the Snapmaker J1X for the first layer consistency. Since the default setting of the low-band software for the first layer thickness is 0.28 mm, so I choose 0.28 mm at the thickness of the first layer and printed the first layer at 25 locations across the entire heatband and measured the thickness of each piece with a micrometer. I measured the thickness of the first layer of 25 pieces with a micrometer and recorded them in order to generate a graph. This is the chart of the recorded thickness of the first layer of each piece. And as you can see, the actual printout will be bigger than the thickness set by the software. But the thickness of the first layer of the 25 pieces fluctuates within a certain range. However, the difference between the largest thickness and the smallest thickness is only 0.06 mm, which is very good result. So I think the Snapmaker J1X has a very good first layer consistency. I'm very happy with its performance. I really like the Snapmaker J1X so far. Next, I will test its extruder by making it retract and move constantly to check if any filament or strings were left on the printed object. I noticed that the low-band software defaults the retraction distance to 1 mm and the retraction speed to 30 mm per second. So I will start printing the honeycomb cylinder with the default settings to see if there are any filament or strings residue. As you can see, under low-band's default retraction distance and retraction speed settings, there will be little filament residue on the honeycomb cylinder surface. In order to verify the effect of changing the extruder retraction distance and retraction speed on the improvement of filament residue, I reset the retraction distance from 1 mm to 1.3 mm and the retraction speed from 30 mm per second to 35 mm per second in the low-band software, and then reprint the honeycomb cylinder to see if the filament residue is reduced. Fortunately, after setting the new retraction parameters, the Snapmaker J1X IDEX 3D printer prints the same honeycomb cylinder, and the filament string residue did improve, and the surface became cleaner. I wanted to check how well the Snapmaker J1X handles different clearances without changing any settings. The model have 7 rotors with clearances ranging from 0.1 mm to 0.5 mm. Using the default settings in low-band and without tweaking any parameters. I print it with the J1S to see how well it performs out of the box. The result shows that the rotor was easily turned with the clearances of 0.3mm, 0.35mm, and 0.5mm, but couldn't be turned with the clearances less than 0.25mm. During the printing process, I do a noise test on the Snapmaker J1X. With the door closed and at a distance of 50 cm from the machine, the working noise was about 56 decibels. And with the door open, the noise rose to about 60 decibels. Overall, the noise is not too loud for me and it is perfectly acceptable. One of the things I like about the IDEX 3D printer is that it allows me to print in two colors, thus making my prints more colorful. Two color printing is a fun process and easy to set up on the Luban software. All you need to do is select an extruder on the Luban software to print a certain part of the model. Once everything is set up, generate a G-code file and send it to the Snapmaker J1X machine. Control and monitor the print process from Luban. And it's all very simple. Printing this model have took a total of 4 hours and 36 minutes in the normal print mode. If it is other 3D printers with a single extruder, it would have taken much longer, or even impossible, because you need to keep changing the PLA filament. Thanks to the dual extruder design of the Snapmaker J1X, it is easier for me to print in two colors. When printing in two extruder, we need to be careful to adjust the axis of adhesion. This is because a transition model cylinder need to be printed to keep the extruder filament wipe when the two extruder are constantly exchanging prints. If the adhesion of this transition model is not be set well, it is easy for the extruder to knock it down during the printing process, resulting in printing failure and wasting a lot of time. I encountered this problem when I was printing this model. After checking, I found that the size of the cylinder model automatically generated by Luban software for wiping the PLA filament was too small. The scale of XY only 20mm, resulting in insufficient adhesion. So I memory set the scale size of XY to 35mm and select the ref adhesion type to enhance the adhesion, and reprint it. The final print ran very well and the quality was impeccable. Another thing I like about the Snapmaker J1S is that it can be designed an extruder that specializes in printing support materials that are easy to remove. With other single extruder 3D printer, there's no way to additionally print easily removable support materials, making it difficult to remove the support. Like this, the support is difficult to remove and the model is not clean. So, the Snapmaker J1X is different. It can assign an extruder to print easily removable support material, making the model very clean. After testing and experience, I recommend the Snapmaker J1S IDEX 3D printer. Its dual extruder printing makes it stand out from the crowd of 3D printers. The J1S has a variety of built-in calibration features that allow the user to easily make calibration at any time, thus enabling the best possible print results. The benefits of dual extruder printing including not only dual color printing but also the ability to print support materials individually, such as easily peelable support materials or water soluble support materials, thus compensating for the difficulty of peeling support materials in 3D printers with a single extruder. What's more, the frame of the Snapmaker J1X IDEX 3D printer is made of aluminum alloy, and the overlock is white and clean, which I like. The wire management inside the Snapmaker J1X is very well done. The internal structure is neatly organized and looks quite comfortable. Okay. This is the Snapmaker J1X IDEX 3D printer for you. I hope my video is helpful to your purchase decision. Please like and follow. See you next time.